Hello students, welcome to the session. In this session, we'll study about the concept of law, meaning, definition and objectives of law. Generally, law means rules and regulation. So it is framed by the government and for the correct conduct of life. That means to regulate the behavior of the people in the society. In the absence of law, lot of confusions takes place, conflict between people arises. So, to avoid this, to maintain peaceful life in the society, law and its amendments, correction, according to the requirement is very important. There is a maxim called ignorantia juris non excusat. That means for ignorance of law, there is no excuse. That means one should not ignore or violate the general law of the country. That means one should know about the general law of the country. For example, law related to the purchase, sales or any transactions between the people, agreement between the people related to sale of property, etc. It doesn't mean that he should know every aspect of the law in detail, but he should know the general law. If he avoid, violates or cause breach of contract, in such a cases he'll be punished. Let us look at the meaning of law. The term law denotes a set of rules of conduct imposed and enforced by the government to bring about peace and order in the society. So the meaning says that it's a set of rules of conduct. Set of rules, it is not one. It includes many rules related to various aspects. It may be related to rules for purchase of goods or sale of goods or agreement, that means for transfer of property, or it may be related to marriage agreement. So there are various types of rules, regulation included. So set of rules of conduct, it is related to the behavior of the people. Imposed and enforced by the government. So it is framed by the government and implemented by the government only. Government or the state, that is the ruling authority. The main intention to bring peace and order in the society. There should not be any conflict, there should not be any crime, or there should not be any litigations. So the main intention to bring peace and order in the society and maintain harmony in the society, so that contribute to the overall development in the society. According to Salmon, law is the body of principles recognized and applied by the state in the administration of justice. So this definition gives the same meaning. It is a body of principles. It is the rules, that is set of rules. That means many rules relating to various aspects are included. And it is recognized and applied by the state. It is identified, it is framed, identified and implemented by the state. That means the government. Usually in the central, the parliament enact the rules, and in a state level, state government or assembly will passes the such a act based on the circumstances. The main intention of these rules in the administration of justice, that means these law, set of rules and regulation applied in managing the activities or giving the justice to the people in various situations in administration. For example, when there is a conflict between A and B, इफ अ केस फाइल्ड अगेंस्ट बी इन द कोर्ट ऑफ लॉ देन द जज डिसाइड और लिसन टू द केस एंड गिव द जजमेंट बेस्ड ऑन द सेट ऑफ रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन related to these aspects. So in case of these administration rules and regulations help to give the judgment. Let us look about one more definition given by Blackstone. As per Blackstone, law is a rule of civil conduct prescribed by supreme power of the state, commanding what is right, prohibiting what is wrong. This definition says that law is a rule of civil conduct. That means it is rules for the behavior of the people in the society, which is prescribed by supreme power. That means the parliament in a central level or state assembly in a state level. And it gives instruction about what is right for any transaction, agreement, or any activities. Law prescribes which is right, what should be done, and prohibiting what is wrong, and which prohibits what is wrong also mentions which should not be done. So this is the meaning of the definition as per Blackstone. Let us look at the features of law. Law is a bundle of rules and principles. As said, it is not a rule related to one aspect. It may be the rules and regulations relating to various aspects related to the activities of people. For example, purchase sales transaction or marriage agreement, or related to establishment, related to the industry or other commercial activities. It relates to external action of humans. So law can control only external behavior, action of the people, and not internal feelings or fear or any angry. Such things cannot be controlled by law. It is made and enforced by the government, means authority. It may be state or central government. So it has the right to pass the act. Law always remains supreme. That means it is the highest, and even the lawmaker is bound to follow it. It is equal to all people. Law is exercised on the people. That means it is not applicable to animals or non-living things. Only people can apply, can follow it, and in case any problem from the animals also, the owner of this is a held responsible, not particular animal, because it is applicable to only people. Law is flexible in the sense it is subject to amendment based on the situation. The law can be amended with the consent of the members in parliament or assembly, and based on the situation or requirement of the people. Law influences the conduct of members of society. That means it regulates. If a person is committing mistake, then law definitely gives punishment, insist punishment on him, and try to correct the behavior of the people. Let us look at the objectives of law. The main objective is to bring about peace and order in the society. In addition to this, the broad objective is to establish socio-economic justice and to remove existing imbalance in socio-economic structure. That is to bring about all-round improvement and welfare of the society. Socio-economic justice, that means justice in respect of social activities, or in respect of financial, economic, or other activities related to culture, and to remove the existing imbalance because of the religion, caste, race, etc. The intention of law is to remove such imbalance or discrimination in the society, and to bring about all-round improvement. That means it may be financial, social improvement, cultural related, or the personality related. So to bring about all these improvement and which contributes to the welfare of the society, that is the intention of. Thank you.